Okay, so I'm sure you've probably heard the words NAFTA or free trade being thrown around recently, but what do they actually mean? Hi, I'm Campbell Barron, and today I'm going to talk to you about NAFTA, also known as the North American Free Trade Agreement, now called the USMCA Agreement.
Many believed this day would never arrive.
This new deal will be the most modern, up-to-date, and balanced trade agreement in the history of our country.
Free and fair trade in North America is in a much more stable place than it was yesterday.
Okay, so to explain this, I've come to a car dealership. This is a brand new Ford Mustang, and a car like this takes months to assemble. Hundreds of parts in this car have been made in Canada, Mexico, and the United States, but you wouldn't know that just by looking at it. And to fully assemble this Mustang, parts have to cross the border up to 8 times. Parts of the car engine were made in Windsor, Ontario, with some of the metal components made in Monterrey, Mexico. And you see, this car over here, it was all put together in Flat Rock, Michigan. Every time that car, or even that car crosses the border, it adds up to the cost of the car. And believe me, these things, they add up fast. So that is where the trade deal comes in. In 1994, when Canada, the USA, and Mexico all came together to agree on trade rules, they were all looking for the best deal. And they tried to come up with a way that the three countries could share the things they make free of high taxes, also called tariffs, which is where the words free trade come from. Earlier this year, President Trump said that the US was done with NAFTA, and NAFTA was quote unquote,
the worst trade deal ever made by any country, I think, in the world.
And that made a lot of people nervous. And after months and months of negotiating, Canada, the USA, and Mexico all had to make concessions in order to come to an agreement. And spoiler alert, some people aren't happy with the new deal either.
The deal may have a new name, but we've signed a deal that's worse than the previous one.
And you see, USMCA is eventually going to affect the price of these cars. However, cars aren't the only thing being affected by free trade. The deal has 34 chapters, covering everything from dairy, medication and clothes, and online shopping. The deal expires in 16 years with a plan to see how things are going in 6 years. As you can see, free trade is a complete brain pretzel.
No minister in a generation has been given a more difficult task than this one.
So now that you're an expert, tell us what you really think about free trade by sending us an email to cbckidsnews@cbc.ca. I'm Campbell Barron for CBC Kids News.